Hey guys, I've been using Private Practice by Dr. Koo Skincare. Dr. Koo is an aesthetic plastic surgeon from my hometown of St. Louis, Missouri. She makes products for clients focused on anti-aging, and there's no shame in that. I'm excited to tell you how it's helped my skin, but first, whenever I start a new skincare routine, I usually do a clean out of my beauty cabinet to get rid of the products that I don't need, aren't right for my skin, and I like to purge all the things I've been gifted that I don't even know what they're for. So I thought it would be fun to have Dr. Koo clean out my beauty cabinet instead and streamline it down to the essentials. Stay tuned for tomorrow when Dr. Koo weighs in on what stays and what goes, and let me know if you've tried anything that you see on these shelves. Hey guys, Bianca here again to discuss beauty because, as promised, Dr. Koo, whose products I've been using for the past few months, she's agreed to look into my beauty cabinet.
Bianca, I am so excited to see your medicine cabinet
that I have here in my bathroom and kind of go through it, help me streamline it and decide what I should keep, what I don't need, what should definitely, you know, not be in my beauty cabinet, what should definitely be in my beauty cabinet, like her products. But I've got a lot of stuff in here.
This is very, very common. Tons of stuff. It's okay that you have things you love in there.
Stuff that relates to skincare topicals, but also different kinds of like gadgets, things that I have for spray tanning, for hair removal, microneedling tools, and all of that. So we're gonna go through it level by level and we'll see what her responses are. Starting with the first level, which are my pimple eliminators. I've got some products that are good for like overnight, good as overnight topicals, and then Zit Sticker, which are these amazing medicated stickers.
Whatever blemish products work, that's the one you should use. Just be very careful that it's not too harsh. And never forget that retinol actually very much controls blemishes.
I have a derma rolling tool. I'm not sure, should I be derma rolling myself? I know it's very trendy, but is it good for my skin?
I do want to address the derma roller. Just be very careful that it's extremely gentle. You can exfoliate much more effectively than using one of those that are too abrasive and they actually can damage your skin. Skincare is all about preserving and being healthy and protecting the skin, not necessarily stripping with harsh chemicals or even a derma roller. So be very careful. I'm not a big fan of derma rollers or brushes that are too harsh.
And then this is an Erno Laszlo vitamin C mask, which I do like once every 2 months or something like that.
Oh, love the barrettes. Your vitamin C mask, Erno Laszlo is a really great brand. So if it's gentle enough, if it penetrates, look at the vitamin C. Is it tetrahexyl ascorbate, or is it a vitamin C that degrades? If you've had that product a long time, that vitamin C you think is penetrating into your skin to make it brighter and healthier may not be doing what you think it is. So vitamin C, short half-life, make sure it's the one that's stable.
Then the next level down, I've got my face mask that I do a couple times a week, maybe two or three times a week. Everything from a black tea perfecting mask from Fresh to a mud mask.
Masks are great. Once a week, most masks can be draining and actually leach and take away too much oil, which is your protective layer on your face. So make sure that they are gentle. But certainly once a week or every couple weeks, using the proper mask to relax and have the experience is a great thing. It can also clean out your pores. Just be very careful and look at the ingredients.
And then I've got my different essences and makeup removers and all of that that I use.
Makeup remover, I'm a big believer in separate makeup removers, separate from your cleansing wash, because your makeup remover, your eyes should have something extremely gentle, maybe even oil-based or cream-based to remove the makeup, or pads that are oil or cream-based, whatever works for your skin, and eyes are very sensitive.
Over here, I have to lift my breaths. We have my deodorants that range from aluminum, like that guy, to natural deodorants, which are, I know, healthier for my body. And that spray guy is also all natural.
The deodorant, make sure don't have aluminum in your deodorant. You don't have to use au naturel. Baking soda also is great to add with any deodorant. Try to use anything that does not have aluminum in it.
When we go down a level, I've got my castor oil for eyebrows, and then these are my eye creams, one from Dermalogica, one from Verst. They both have vitamin C in them.
Eye creams, great, you must have them. I have one that has retinol in it that is very specific and very gentle. Eye creams are meant to calm the crepiness of your eyes and the puffiness and the dark circles. So you have to be careful, again, the purity of the ingredients. If it works for you and it's doing the trick, then it's a good product.
So this section is what I call my exfoliation section because it has a lot of vitamin C products, a more natural version of a retinol, and then these are classic retinols, one from Sunday Riley and one from First Aid Beauty.
Let's address the retinols because that's one of my favorite and specialties. You want retinols because it changes your skin and is effective. Natural retinols, unless it's bakuchiol, probably is not going to get the job done to increase the plumpness or the brightness of your skin.
And then, of course, my night creams, one from Olay and then another one from First Aid Beauty.
Choose the hydration or the moisturizer that is appropriate for your skin. If it's winter, the heavier, more creamy one's perfect.
My AM, like daytime products. So I like really light moisturizers like this one from Purity, and then this one from Verst, which is like a dewy gel cream. And then this is thicker. That one is from Botanix. And there's one from Good Science Beauty.
The lighter one should be water-based, and it's because your skin in the T-zone can be a little oily, so you want them water-based. The lighter serum's perfect for hydrators.
And these are my beauty oils, which I use for gua sha and face scrubbing or brushing, whatever you call that. When it comes to face oils, I don't know what I should be looking for. I just have kept the face oils that I like the kind of the consistency and the fragrance and just the viscosity of. So those are the ones that end up in my beauty cabinet. I really like this one because it's super light.
Face oils, wonderful, but please, no fragrance, okay? Viscosity, great word. I'm all about the texture and the lightness of your products. If you love a light product, that viscosity for your type of oily skin or heavy pores, that's the one for you. If you have very dry skin, the creamier, the more emollient, the more ceramides, the better.
And then these are my spray tanning products. I mean, I'm not gonna get rid of those because I need to be spray tanned. I need to be bronzed, Dr. Ku.
You're spray tanning, that's a must. You gotta look beautiful. I'm proud of you, it's okay. Don't go in the real sun. Spray tanning's a great substitute.
And lip care, I always use Vaseline, lip therapy, and Kapari has a nice scrub, and of course Carmex in the winter. I don't really use that in the summer.
And then the lip care, a must, especially in the winter, and don't forget the SPF in there.
So lowering down, this is like the immediate stuff I need. I love any kind of face cleanser that is in between creamy and foamy. And this is my face, like my vibrating facial brush.
Facial brush, it looked like it was a little rubber and soft, so that's all right, I'm okay with that. Little gentle brush to exfoliate, clean up the pores. It's all about the cleanser you use though.
Then I've got some misters. I've got this Rose Deep Hydration Facial Toner, which I absolutely love because let me show you, it has pieces of rose in there, like petals. It's also from Fresh. Let me know what you think about that toner, Dr. Ku.
Your rose toner, it's great. If you love that and it feels really good and it brightens and freshens your skin, it's not gonna harm it. It's probably mostly water, to be honest, but I'm a little concerned if you got rose petals in there and it's disintegrating and turning a little rancid. I'd be a little careful about what's accumulating in there.
And look, I have Dr. Ku products. Those are front and center because I use those daily, AM and PM.
I'm glad you have my products in there. My products are curated because each product, each ingredient has a purpose. It's packed with chemistry, medical facts, and truth. If you don't know what something is doing, contact my office. I'll tell you what it's doing and each ingredient in there.
And back here, I have a micellar water, which I don't use very often because I don't really know what micellar water is for. That was another gifted product.
So if you don't know what it's doing, probably pitch it, clean up, and simplify your medicine cabinet.
Moving on back here, I have an Elemis Pro Collagen Cleansing Balm. That's one of those oily facial cleansers that is really great for removing makeup. So I really only use it when I have a ton of makeup on that I want to get off. And then this is a very exfoliating polish, which I don't use that often because I feel that it's very harsh on my skin.
The gentler, the better. It's okay if you have oily skin and you need exfoliation, but a lot of exfoliating cleansers have salicylic acid and ingredients that you're probably not going to necessarily want to use because it's too stripping, too harsh. It's not that your skin is sensitive, but the products are too rough. They're just too harsh.
And this is my favorite part, Dr. Ku, of my beauty cabinet because it is my SPF. And I just want to prove to you that I use it because I know when you are above the age of 35, but literally any age, you should really, really be focused on protecting your skin because honestly, the sun does not do aging skin any favors. But listen, you should use SPF at any age. And I totally subscribe to that. So I have the Olay Regenerous Mineral Sunscreen in 15 and 30. I have it in La Roche in 50. I even have an eye sunscreen in 30.
1000% SPF is your friend. However, I'm going to give you a tip right here. The higher the SPF does not mean that it's necessarily good for you. Here's a word of caution, and here's what I would advise. You do not need an SPF higher than 35 to 45. The higher your SPF, the less your UVA protection. UVA protection is what ages and damages your skin. The UVB is for cancer, but the higher your SPF, the lower your UVA protection.
And then CE, ferulic acid, which I hear is really important to use under your sunscreen. I'm still a little confused about CE ferulic and what it does, but it's there. And my most important question related to CE ferulic is, does it expire?
CE ferulic, a little bit of a buzzword. Vitamin C, a must, but yes, there is an expiration date. That is why I talk about stable vitamin C. It is for brightening your skin. It is a component for collagen and elastin production. So you do need it, but be careful of your formulation.
So that is my beauty cabinet. I have one of these crazy face shaving little razors, which I cut myself with using the first time, so I've really been petrified of it. Should I use this? Is shaving your face as good as all those TikTok videos say it is? Let me know, Dr. Ku.
To me, that's a no, no, and no. Too rough, too deep. You can cut, you can get bacterial infections. Now, sometimes I have patients that love those because it removes their peach fuzz. If you're doing it for that, do it very gently and very lightly in an even, simple plane so that you don't hurt your skin.